In 1793, an estimated 100 black people were held as slaves in Upper Canada. By 1820, the slaves were freed. By the time slavery was abolished in the United States in 1865, about 100,000 southern slaves had escaped either to the northern states or to Canada by a route known as the Underground Railroad. Now a Toronto playwright and religious elder creates the Israelite Nation. This organization promotes the belief that North Americans of African descent, like the Jews, can also claim to be a people of the book. It's the subject of a new play.
Well, Moses died in the land of Ur.
Let my people go.
Where he was buried had never been told.
Let my people go.
I'm singing now, go down.
My lips can't repeat the things they did to that woman. Took the boy, tied him up to a tree, right for her, and they whoop him until all the blood drained out his back. Then they drag him. They put him in a mule car. Mass Evans, he stood there with all his yellow-looking tobacco teeth and did nothing.
About 15 to 20 million blacks died. That is almost the population of black America, which is about 22 million, I suppose. Those are just that passed through the Middle Passage. They died before, even in Africa. And when they came here, they died too. When I'm saying here, I'm talking about North America.
Amen.
No, no. No singing. Not till we cross over.
Shh. You hear that?
What?
Listen.
What?
You hear that? Listen. Hear what? The sound of water, girl.
Water?
Let's go pray and give the good Lord thanks.
Oh.
Not now. We got to cross over.
No. We got to pray now.
Mm-hmm.
Look how many of us started out, and it's only us five left here now.
Mm-hmm.
We got to pray now.
There's that part of us in each one of the characters. It's just a matter of focusing to bring yourself to that point and to imagine what it must have been like.
My baby was only 9 months old. I can still see the eyes looking up at my face. Mm-hmm. I can still feel the warmth of his body in my arms.
Mm-hmm.
And in the distance, I can hear him cry.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Mass had hit my face and threw my body to the ground. I scrambled to save my baby.
At first, I didn't feel the role. But then once you go through all the script, once you see the play in totality, you look at everything and you see the emotions, you see all the stories from everyone, and you can't help but feel it.
Did you ever see him again, Miss Ruth? Once I thought when they hung on Natty by that old tree, that I'd see his face. I wasn't sure. The face of that little boy that was watching me reached deep down inside of me.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
A feeling only a mother can feel.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. He had those same eyes.
Mm-hmm.
He was so handsome. And my breast jumped like the spirit touching
me.
And I feel it in my bones that he was my boy.
Mm-hmm.
When the time comes for me to run away, a master catch me, I kill myself first before I go back.
Mm-hmm.
For me, playing Elijah took a while to get used to his character. Like, he's an old man. And, you know, and he made it to Canada, which, you know, took a lot of guts and a lot of zeal in that area. But his character, when you take on that role, there's a lot of pain.
That's right.
If I'm dead, they can't beat me no more.
Right.
The point where people might turn crazy is the point of being in the bushes and not knowing what's around the corner, what's around the next block. The bloodhounds racing after me and running through the swamps and hearing the voices.
He was my brother!
come out of my mama's belly together. And they shot him right here. They killed him, but I beat him. I'm in Canada now.
Having the guts to actually say, okay, even what I've seen people get caught and brought back, I'm going to try it now. And going through all of that and then being in the bushes, and you're actually there now.
Where's Canada? Is that like that old Jordan story your Natty used to tell?
Canada's the land of the queen. A free land for God's people. I hear we can sing again in Canada. Mm-hmm. I hear there are lots of trees in Canada. Mm-hmm. No master, no slave. Mm-hmm. We're free in Canada.
They used to talk about Canada being the promised land, and they used to talk about Israel being the promised land. And these are all slave stories that they used to tell, but they never could connect it so that the scriptures might be fulfilled. And we look at America as being even Egypt, because with all the obelisks and all the symbols of Egypt, the Eye of Horus and everything. So we see that as the second Egypt. We try to use that, to dig deep within the soul, so that people can feel this type of a feeling that really belongs to us. We've just been sitting on it. We just need to get up and unfold our hands. The American slaves that rebelled, they saw themselves as the children of Israel in the Bible.
Take that rod that's in your hand, cross the Red Sea.
And that was erased during the period of time. Until recently, it's been resurrected. We're beginning to see ourselves in the scriptures. And we look at all the situations that happened during the time of slavery. We look at their names, and all the names are biblical. And you look at the situation, everything about them is spiritual. I first got into theater as a critic. I used to be a writer under the name Grapevine I'm from Guyana. And I came here, and in 1983, but spiritually, there was something much more needed for me to do. And that was to teach the gospel, so to speak. So I began to write in the old contrast paper about how I see the Bible, how I perceive the Bible, and how I see myself in the Bible and people like me in the Bible. And the response was great. And that was the beginning of this whole structure of the Israelite nation. And as far as the acting is concerned, is how you project what you feel inside, because I always believed that we were very talented people.
We by the water.
It's a very sad thing where you never have an outlet to express yourself, whether it be emotionally, spiritually, dramatically, through arts, through dance, through song, whatever. And I think that this is something that has been fruitful and been useful to us.
Wait by the water.
Yes, Lord, we saw the light by the window and was made stronger than our pain.
One person said to me that they went to visit somewhere in the South where the slave lived. And this organization that took them there was explaining, and this is where they slept, this is how they did. And it all appears to the crowd that it happened to somebody else. It didn't happen to me. Unlike what the Jews are doing, they're feeling it. And this is something that I try to do with a play, to allow the actors to feel it.
You have brought us forth from bondage into a new promised land. Our eyes have seen the rage, but we keep holding on to your hand.